In April 2023, the following new features and updates were released by PVcase. A new header line called Layout Name has been added to the Layout Information tab. This allows to rename each layout generated before the table is exported to the Excel file. Just type in the desired name and then select Export to XLSX. The Project Overview tab in the generated file will show a header line with the desired layout name. When using the recently renovated KLink tab, the settings would be the same for the DC, AC, and HV cabling types. If different settings were needed, the user had to update each time when toggling amongst them. Now, these settings are stored for each cabling type separately, making it more convenient for the user to keep consistent settings for each cabling type. Designers wanting to show the pile locations in the model space can do so by clicking on Show Piling in the PVcase top ribbon or by typing Generate Piling in the AutoCAD command bar. The default piling icon generated would be a 3D solid square object. This could already be changed to a 3D polyline circle object by toggling the options in the AutoCAD command bar. Now, in addition to the 3D object, an additional point object is provided at the center of each pile. To avoid using the incorrect location for generation of a PV layout or for shading calculations, the user is now prompted to select that the project location needs to be changed. In this manner, the user avoids accidentally designing at the PVcase default location in Kaunas. As requested by the users of the east-west framing type, now it is possible to select a fixed distance in between rows and also defined corridors. These are useful to leave adequate spacing for roads or trenches. In order to do this, open the Park Settings tab, check the Fixed Distance box, and click on Corridors. A new window will open where the corridor pattern, gaps, and lines can be selected. We hope you enjoy these new features. Please let us know how we're doing and reach out with your comments and questions.